All right. So a very warm welcome to everyone present here. Thank you so much for coming. This is the Binance India team, and we have Naimish here, who's our guest for today's webinar. Naimish is the founder of CoinCrunch. Many of us know him already. Today we'll be starting with a step-by-step slide on how to do P2P exchange in India using INR. So for that, a P2P team member here, Chitral, will be guiding you guys. We'll take you guys through a slide. There'll also be a question and answer round. So you guys can, hold up your questions for the end of the session. And we should begin with that. Also before moving forward, we have some exciting news for you guys. After our webinar is over, we'll be, giving out 20 USD worth of coupons to everyone who uses P2P platform and, does trading above $100. So Chitral, I'm handing it over to you so you can proceed ahead.
Sure, thank you. It's a pleasure to be the part of this webinar today and part of the Binance team. So to begin with, actually there are a lot of people who are
अपन हिंदी में करते हैं ना ये
अच्छा हिंदी में तो actually मैं कोशिश करती हूँ कुछ words ऐसे होंगे जो
yeah
okay cool. Okay, so Binance P2P. So let's start with Binance P2P kya hai. Sabse pehle to P2P kya hai. P2P is peer to peer. It means ki hum mere jaise main aur aap aapas mein kuch exchange kar rahe hain. Jaise hum e-commerce platform pe kahin pe kuch bhi buy sell karte hain, to ek buyer hota hai, ek seller hota hai. Jo buyer hota hai, wo apni product ka ad place karta hai marketplace pe, and jo buyer hota hai. वो आके अगर उसको प्राइस वगैरह सब ठीक लगता है तो वो परचेज करता है. सो सिमिलरली दैट इज द सेम केस विद क्रिप्टो P2P. एक बायर होता है, एक सेलर होता है. एक बायर होता है जिसको क्रिप्टोस चाहिए, और एक सेलर होता है जिसको क्रिप्टोस अपने बेचने हैं. तो ये जो P2P प्लेटफॉर्म है जिसमें आपस में आप एक दूसरे के साथ ट्रांजेक्शन कर सकते हैं. सो अगर आपने किसी से क्रिप्टो खरीदे हैं तो आप उसको पेमेंट करेंगे. पेमेंट कैसे करेंगे? पीयर टू पीयर में वो बैंक डिटेल्स अपनी प्रोवाइड करेगा. वो मर्चेंट हो सकता है या आपके जैसा हमारे जैसा एक यूजर भी हो सकता है. सो Binance P2P जो है, Binance P2P एक प्लेटफॉर्म, एक मार्केट प्लेस प्रोवाइड करता है जहाँ बायर और सेलर आके, या तो अब उसमें दो तरीके से होता है. एक कि ऑलरेडी जो ऑफर्स लिस्ट होती है उसमें से अगर आपके आपके क्या कहते हैं उसे, इफ इफ इट्स अफोर्डेबल, इफ इट्स सूटेबल टू यू, आप उसको इसी ऑफर को लोगे. अगर आपको सूटेबल नहीं है तो आप अपना एड खुद से प्लेस कर सकते हो. आई एम रियली वेरी सॉरी मैं हिंदी में फर्स्ट टाइम कर रही हूँ, सो दैट विल बी सम
We have started a war on the comment section already.
So. Oh, okay. I'll try to manage between both English and Hindi. Okay.
I think that would be good.
Yeah. Okay. So now, जो आज हमारा presentation, जो हमारा webinar है, that is, so I'm going to cover three main topics. First is what is Binance P2P. Second is why buying and selling crypto through Binance P2P and how to use Binance P2P. Third point is very important, क्योंकि आप INR से Binance P2P पे क्रिप्टोज यानी बिटकॉइंस, इथेरियम, BNB, BUSD खरीद सकते हैं, बेच सकते हैं. सो व्हाट इज Binance P2P? एज आई एक्सप्लेन, देर आर टू डिफरेंट यूजर्स, एक बायर है, एक सेलर है. जो बायर है वो अपना एड प्लेस करता है पीयर टू पीयर प्लेटफॉर्म पे, और जो जो सेलर होता है वो एड प्लेस करता है. जो बायर होता है वो आके अपने जो भी ऑफर्स लिस्टेड है, दे गो थ्रू दैट ऑफर्स, एंड उसमें से जो उसको सुटेबल लगता है, द बेस्ट ऑफर, वो उसको सिलेक्ट करके ऑर्डर प्लेस करता है. जैसे ही ऑर्डर प्लेस करता है तो जो सेलर होता है वो अपने क्रिप्टोज रिलीज करता है. वो प्रोसेस पूरा मैं आपको आगे प्रैक्टिकली भी समझाऊंगी. ऑन Binance P2P, व्हाट आर द कॉइन्स दैट वी सपोर्ट एंड व्हाट आर द करेंसीज दैट वी सपोर्ट करेंटली, एस्पेशली फॉर इंडिया. वी विल बी टॉकिंग फॉर इंडिया. अब Binance P2P पे वी हैव बिटकॉइन, वी हैव USDT, वी हैव इथेरियम, वी हैव EOS, वी हैव Binance टोकन BNB, एंड वी हैव Binance स्टेबल कॉइन BUSD. अभी तक हमारे कितने ट्रांजेक्शन्स हुए हैं? दैट इज टोटल it's 1 billion plus US dollars. We support 33 fiat currencies. For India, we support 7 currencies for now. And in case, agar jo merchant hai, jo high volume trader hai, they want to list a currency, we have a special form that you have to fill in. You have to show the proof that you deal in those currencies, and we list those currencies also depending on the compliance in our country. And the main thing that Binance P2P offers is zero transaction fees. So whenever you place an order or carry out any transaction, Binance doesn't charge anything from that transaction. Now, what are the use cases that Binance P2P platform offers to you? Sabse pehle, buy and sell crypto. So being in India, जहाँ पे हो कभी कभार बैंकिंग जो सपोर्ट नहीं करता है, इन दैट केस पीयर टू पीयर प्लेटफॉर्म प्लेज अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल. सो यू कैन डायरेक्टली बाय एंड सेल क्रिप्टो करेंसीज, जो मैंने आके आपको बताया, बिटकॉइन, इथेरियम, बीयूएसडी, बीएनबी एंड ईओएस, दैट यू कैन डायरेक्टली बाय वाया आईएनआर एंड दैट ऑल्सो विद जीरो फीस. सेकेंड इज यू कैन मेक मनी. There are a lot of merchants, those who place their ads on our platform, and us sare ads ke beech mein there are price differences that you will see. A person selling one Bitcoin at say $9,000, another person will be selling at $9,500. So what as a user you can have benefit is from the arbitrage, that is you can buy at lower price and sell at higher price. So aap iska jo margin hai beech mein uska bhi aap uska fayda utha sakte hain. And lastly, it's remittance. Remittance is, say for example, today I'm in India, tomorrow I got a job in Singapore and I shift to Singapore. So abhi Singapore mein jo mujhe salary milegi, I want to send that back to India. So what I will do is, main us Singapore dollar se, I will buy cryptos and I will sell that in INR and get INR in my bank account, and so I can transfer my money from Singapore to India easily. Why Binance P2P? This is very important. Other fiat on ramps versus Binance P2P. Fiat on ramps ka matlab hai directly when there is bank account linked and you deal with the exchanges and buy and sell. And what is Binance P2P? So first is the Forbit. In Forbit, if I talk, there is a direct deposit and withdrawal via bank account. So aap exchange ke अकाउंट में डिपॉजिट करते हैं एंड देन एक्सचेंज.
कैन यू प्लीज प्रेजेंट द स्क्रीन? कैन यू प्लीज प्रेजेंट द स्क्रीन? या थैंक यू,
वेलकम. सॉरी, या सो इज इट विजिबल नाउ?
यस, इट्स अ लॉट बेटर.
ओके, थैंक्स. So, yeah, so format ye hota hai ki if you are dealing on fiat on ramps, you directly deposit in the exchange bank account and the exchange releases the coin into your wallet. Binance P2P mein kya hota hai? Binance platform provides escrow services and offline fiat transactions. Now, what is escrow services? Ek jo major question aata hai users ke mind mein ki I am dealing with somebody unknown to me. So, what if I pay to that person and that person, the user, runs away with my money without giving me crypto? To solve this problem, Binance provides escrow services where jab ek seller apna ad place karta hai, say for example he wants to sell 100 USDT, to wo 100 USDT Binance ke escrow services mein fund mein reserve ho jate hain. Ab jab buyer hota hai wo usko payment deta hai, to payment karne ke baad wo confirm karta hai I paid karke. एंड जैसे ही वो कन्फर्मेशन आता है तो मर्चेंट जो होता है सेलर, उसके पास ऑप्शन होता है टू रिलीज द क्रिप्टो. अब इन केस वो भूल जाता है, इन केस उसको डिले हो जाता है क्रिप्टो रिलीज करने में, तो जो बायर होता है वो अपील कर सकता है, वो कस्टमर कॉन्टैक्ट कर सकता है बाइनेंस कस्टमर केयर को. बाइनेंस कस्टमर केयर ट्राई करेगा कि वो मर्चेंट को कॉन्टैक्ट करके उसको ही बोले कि आप क्रिप्टो रिलीज करो. अदरवाइज अगर वहाँ से रिस्पॉन्स नहीं मिलता है तो बाइनेंस खुद से ही क्रिप्टो रिलीज कर देता है. So this is the problem that Binance has solved. I'll repeat in English. Say for example, there is a seller who places an ad on Binance P2P platform and pays to the merchant. Now, if in case the merchant delays the payment or forgets to release the crypto, in that case, the buyer can contact customer support, and the customer support will contact the merchant first. If the merchant doesn't respond, Binance, our team, will release the crypto to the buyer. So in that case, buyer is also saved in this format. Fiat payment is directly you go through the trusted party, and here it is between the users. You pay fiat money, that is INR, to the seller, and you get the cryptos. Generally on fiat on REMS, there are 1 to 2 payment methods, that is bank transfer. You can do IMPS or NEFT, RTGS, which works in India. Whereas on Binance P2P, we have 50 plus payment method options, and we are adding more. I will show you what's there for India. So you have bank transfer, you have UPI also, and we are adding many more payment methods as well. Now, what are the fee structures? When you use a fiat on ramp, you have to pay, if you're using credit card services or anything, up to a certain amount, or you are exceeding, then you have to pay transaction fees as well. Whereas in P2P, Binance is not charging any fees from either the buyer or the seller. So jo bhi jo ad post karte hai uska bhi koi fees nahi hai. Jo advertiser hai, for example, if I am the seller, main sirf apna margin rakhungi. Say market price abhi bitcoin ka it's $9,000, to main apna ek margin rakhti hu $100 ka. So isme Binance doesn't charge anything from me or the buyer. Talking about the price, so user can take only the given price. On fiat on ramps mein jo exchange ne price list ki hoti hai, aapko usi price pe buy karna padta hai. Binance P2P mein the both you can set or take the price. For example, as I said, ki if I am a say buyer, agar mere merchants mein se, merchant list mein se mujhe koi suitable lagta hai mere accordingly, to I will either buy, ya to main apna ek alag se advertisement post karungi ki I want to buy at this price. So agar koi seller hoga to wo aapko contact karega. Transaction limits, it's decided on Binance P2P, it is decided by the buyer and the seller, which I will show you practically. Talking about our roadmaps, we are very well on track. So we started the project in August 2019, and right now if I talk about the late last 3 months, we have been adding more and more currencies. Right now we support 33 currencies. We have done $1.5 billion plus, and we have added 50 plus new methods, payment methods, and much more is coming up. Now, how to use Binance P2P? First of all, you need to have a Binance account. If you don't have a Binance account, please create one today. If you have a Binance account, can you see my screen?
Yeah, we can.
Okay. So if you have a Binance account and if you log in, you can, on the top left corner, you can see there are 3 methods under buy crypto in INR. So you have to click the second one, which is P2P crypto exchange. Ab agar aapko P2P crypto exchange use karna hai, so there are 2 things which are very much mandatory. One is you have to do your KYC, and second is you have to enable the SMS authentication. In the application, if you open up, aapka jo home page, home screen rahega, uske center mein you will see an option buy with cash. Jaise hi usko aap click karoge, aapko फर्स्ट स्क्रीन पे यहाँ पे बॉटम की तरफ 2 ऑप्शंस दिखेंगे, P2P एंड फियाट. यू हैव टू क्लिक ऑन P2P. जैसे ही आप P2P पे क्लिक करोगे, आपको ये वाला स्क्रीन दिखेगा. सो दिस इज इन INR स्क्रीन. नाउ लेट्स से फॉर एग्जांपल यू वांट टू बाय, तो यू हैव टू क्लिक ऑन बाय. ऑल्सो यू हैव योर फिल्टर वेयर यू कैन फिल्टर योर फियाट करेंसीज इन विच यू वॉन्ट टू बाय. You can set that in INR. After clicking this thing, you have to click on buy. Say for example, mujhe in 3 jo options yahan pe jo merchants ne place kiya. Ab yahan pe aapko ye jo yellow mark dikh raha hai, that is Binance verified merchants. So Binance merchant program mein we are aggressively inviting applications from merchants who have reliable source of fiat and crypto to join us to bring liquidity on our platform, and we verify them. So once you see this yellow symbol, so for example, I want to buy from this user because I feel it's a, he's a verified user. So I'll click on buy. After selecting buy, I'll be taken to this screen. Now I have to enter the amount, how much amount of crypto I want to, USDT I want to buy. उसमें पेमेंट मेथड्स आपको दिखेंगे. सो देर आर ऑल जिसमें अभी हम सपोर्ट करते हैं बैंक एलिपे एंड वीचैट क्विवी एंड अभी आपको यूपीआई ऑप्शन भी दिखेगा एंड यू हैव टू सिलेक्ट आईएनआर एंड देन क्लिक यस. आफ्टर क्लिकिंग यस देन यू कैन क्लिक ऑन बाय. वंस यू क्लिक बाय से फॉर एग्जांपल आई एम जस्ट शोइंग हियर. Once you click here buy, your order will be placed. Once your order will be placed, you will be redirected to another page. I'm sorry, I'll have to also cancel this order quickly. तो आपको ये वाला पेज दिखेगा जहाँ पे आपको ऑर्डर नंबर दिखेगा, क्वांटिटी दिखेगा, अमाउंट दिखेगा एंड द रेसिपिएंट नेम एंड अकाउंट डिटेल्स एंड यू हैव टू ट्रांसफर टू दैट पर्सन अकाउंट.
The screen is stuck at your desktop presentation. Okay, we can't really see what if you are showing something else.
Oh, can you not see my screen?
We can see, but we see the presentation. Like, I think you are giving a demo, right, from your phone or something?
Yeah, I'm giving demo from my account.
But we can't see. We are not seeing that screen.
Can you see now?
Still the presentation only.
It's showing me here that this the screen is being presented.
Perhaps it's a fixed screen of this presentation. So maybe just stop streaming and then start again. Okay, yeah. Now we see the Binance.com screen. Yeah.
This is you can see, right? The orders.
Yes.
Okay, cool. Fine. Sorry. Okay, so coming back once again, say for example, you have logged into your Binance account and now you are at the P2P platform. So again, once you log into the Binance account, when you want to buy crypto via INR, you can go to the top left corner and you can select the second option, which is P2P crypto exchange. Once you click on that option, you'll be landed to this page where you will see I want to buy and I want to sell. Let's say for example you want to buy. So आपके पास ये जो यहाँ पे merchants है वो सारे आपको offers दिखेंगे, different offers. अब इस merchants में आपको दिखेंगे number of orders, percentage of completion. So number of orders मतलब इस merchant ने इतने orders already successfully complete कर चुके हैं. This is the price that you can see. Available कितने हैं उनके पास USDT वो आपको दिखेंगे. The limit can be set by the seller. That is, जो great BTC buy है उनको minimum तो 10,000 उनको sell करना ही करना है and maximum he can sell is this much what he has in his fiat wallet. तो once you play one, say for example you want to buy from great BTC buy, so you will click on buy USDT. यहाँ पे आप अपना अमाउंट डाल सकते हैं जितने अमाउंट का आपको क्रिप्टो परचेज करना है. अगर आपको पूरा क्वांटिटी चाहिए तो यू कैन क्लिक ऑन ऑल. यहाँ पे आपको ऑप्शन दिखेगा इन ये जो मर्चेंट है उन्होंने बैंक ट्रांसफर रखा हुआ है, सो यू कैन क्लिक ऑन बाय नाउ. यू हैव सक्सेसफुली प्लेस्ड एन ऑर्डर. अब वो आपको अलग दूसरे स्क्रीन पे लेके जाएंगे. सो ऑन दिस स्क्रीन व्हाट यू विल सी इज द प्राइस दैट यू हैव अग्रीड ऑन, द क्वांटिटी, the bank account details. What you have to do is copy and paste, go to your banking app, copy paste all the details and make the transfer. Ab jab aap transfer kar dete ho to you have to click this option transferred and next. Jo main abhi aapko there are many tutorials. I think Naimish has also created one tutorial. You can visit that tutorial and see the whole process how it works. सो इस तरह से ये पूरा काम करता है. अब यहाँ पे जो राइट हैंड साइड पे है दैट इज अ चैट बॉक्स. चैट बॉक्स इज दैट यू कैन डायरेक्टली चैट विद द मर्चेंट. सो इन केस देर इज सम कंफ्यूजन और डिले इन पेमेंट और वॉट एवर, यू कैन डायरेक्टली चैट विद द मर्चेंट. सो दैट इज ऑल अबाउट बाइंग एंड सेलिंग क्रिप्टो. नाउ हाउ टू पोस्ट योर ट्रेड एड्स. अगर आप डायरेक्ट बाय सेल करते हो तो दैट वाज द प्रोसेस. नाउ से फॉर एग्जांपल यू वांट टू पोस्ट योर ट्रेड एड, आपने जितने भी ऑफर्स किए उस लिस्ट में से आपको कोई सुटेबल नहीं लगा एंड यू वांट टू क्रिएट योर ओन एड, दैट इज यू आर अ मेकर. सो व्हाट यू विल डू इज देयर इज एन ऑप्शन इन द एप्लीकेशन. अभी फिलहाल यू कैन प्लेस ट्रेड एड्स ओनली वाया मोबाइल ऐप. सो यू हैव टू ओपन योर मोबाइल ऐप, क्लिक ऑन दिस प्लस बटन. वंस यू क्लिक ऑन दिस प्लस बटन, there will be option to buy or sell. You want to buy or you want to place sell it. You have to select the asset which you are holding, say USDT, BTC, BNB, BUSD, whatever. And you have to select your fiat, which is INR in our case. You have to set the price. A price to type, there are two types of price at. One is floating and second one is fixed. Now, what is floating at? As you know, cryptocurrency market mein fluctuations hota rehta hai. Every 30 seconds, 1 minute mein, there are a lot of fluctuation in prices that happens. So, jo buyer ya seller hota hai, uske control mein hai ki agar usko fixed price pe rakhna hai, jo fluctuate market ke related nahi hai, what is fixed, so he can select fixed. But agar ho sakta hai ki kuch delay ho aur market mein bahut zyada fluctuation aaye, in that case floating price is important. So the person can set the floating price. A floating price aap kitne margin mein rakh sakte ho, so that varies between 80 to 100%. So agar aap aur floating price margin ho, jo hai, that is margin that you are adding on it. Say for example I want to sell you 10 USDT. तो मैं अपना जो फ्लोटिंग प्राइस मार्जिन होता है दैट आई कैन प्लेस फ्रॉम 80 to 120. से फॉर एग्जांपल आई प्लेस ऑन 120, तो 120 तक का अगर फ्लक्चुएशन जो प्राइस पे होता है तो उस टाइम पे जो बायर आता है, अगर मैं सेल कर रही हूँ और जो बायर आता है उस टाइम पे, वहाँ पे एवरी मिनट द प्राइस रिफ्रेशेस एंड द बायर हैज़ टू क्लिक ऑन द रिफ्रेशिंग बटन, सो दैट द प्राइस जो मेरा फ्लोटिंग प्राइस मार्जिन है उसको एडजस्ट करके नया प्राइस रिफ्लेक्ट करेगा आपको. सो व्हाइल प्लेसिंग द एड, दिस इज व्हाट यू कैन कंट्रोल. देन यू हैव टू क्लिक ऑन नेक्स्ट. आफ्टर क्लिकिंग ऑन नेक्स्ट यू हैव टू एंटर योर अमाउंट. यू कैन ऑल्सो प्लेस ऑर्डर लिमिट. आज मैं सपोज 100 USDT होल्ड करती हूँ एंड आई एम श्योर के देर आर सो मेनी पीपल हु मे वॉन्ट टू बाई 50 USDT फॉर नाउ. सो आई विल प्लेस लिमिट फ्रॉम 50 to 100, so that if somebody also wants to buy in smaller fraction, they also can buy from me. So that is what order limit is. Maximum I can place 100. You have to select the payment method and payment time limit. Now payment time limit also varies between 15 minutes to 6 hours. Agar yahan pe jo main set karti hu 15 minutes mein, if the buyer doesn't transfer the amount to me in 15 minutes after placing the order will get cancelled. So that is again what the advertiser can control. Once you select next, आपके यहाँ पे remarks auto reply का option भी आता है. Now remarks में आपको specially ध्यान रखना है कि this is very very important for Indian users. You don't have to write, include, mention anything about cryptos, be P2P, C2C, Bitcoin, crypto, anything related to that, so that जो स्क्रूटीनी अगर होता है तो यू आर आउट ऑफ दैट. एंड सेकेंड थिंग इज एनी अदर रिमार्क्स ऑल्सो द मर्चेंट कैन एड. ऑटो रिप्लाई में सपोज आई वॉन्ट टू सेंड अ थैंक यू नोट आफ्टर प्लेसिंग द ऑर्डर, आई विल सेंड थैंक यू नोट. और जो भी मुझे कुछ कम्युनिकेशन करना है, इफ़ आई एम नॉट ऑनलाइन दैट टाइम, तो आई वॉन्ट कि जो बायर है उसको ये नोट इमिजिएटली मिल जाए. सो दैट इज़ वॉट आई कैन सेट इन द ऑटो रिप्लाई. अब मैं कंडीशंस भी सेट कर सकती हूँ अपने हिसाब से कि आई वॉन्ट टू सेल ओनली टू कम्प्लीटेड KYC विच इज़ मैंडेटरी इन आवर केस. रजिस्टर 0 days अगो, मुझे आज किसी ने रजिस्टर किया है तो आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू सेल टू पर्सन हु इज़ रजिस्टर्ड टूडे. सो आई कैन सेट दैट डे ऑल्सो के जिसने भी बाइनेंस P2P पे से 1 month पहले रजिस्टर किया, आई वॉन्ट टू सेल ओनली टू दैट पर्सन. सो आई कैन प्लेस द टिक मार्क एंड एड द नंबर ऑफ डेज. ऑल्सो द पर्सन होल्डिंग some amount of BTC, so if that thing depends, and online or offline again depends on the criteria that you want to set. So this is how you can post your ad, and then you have to publish it. Once you publish, you will be seeing this message that post ad is successful. This will be your order details, and then it's done. And aapka jo home screen hoga, it will be reflected in on the app. So right now, for example, if you are adding UPI payment method, your ad will only be seen on if the person is logging in on the mobile phone. अगर आप वेब पे जाओगे ऑर्डर प्लेस करने के बाद तो आपको अपना एड वेब पे नहीं दिखेगा बिकॉज दैट इज व्हाट स्टिल वी आर वर्किंग ऑन इट एंड वी विल बी रिलीजिंग दैट फीचर आउट वेरी सून. सो यू कैन सी अगर आपने दूसरे पेमेंट मेथड्स ऐड किए तो आपके एड जो है वो मोबाइल ऐप में दिखेंगे. सो दैट्स इट अबाउट ऑल गेटिंग स्टार्टेड विथ योर पी टू पी एंड आई होप टू सी एवरी वन साइनिंग अप फॉर पी टू पी एंड प्लेसिंग योर एड्स एंड स्टार्टिंग स्टार्ट ट्रेडिंग. सो आई थिंक ओवर टू Yeah, Simran, can you hear me?
Yeah, thank you so much, Chitral. Yeah. Really nice. Guys, I know you guys have a lot of questions, but let's hold it up a bit. Right now, like Naimish will take over and you guys can talk to him. He's going to talk about the community, what's the P2P scene in India like, etc. And then we'll take the question and answer round so you guys can, you know, definitely push all your questions on us. So Naimish, I hand it over to you now.
Yeah, hi. Can you hear me, Simran? Chitral?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, great. So thank you so much for having me here. I guess I'm here because I was the one of the first people who did a P2P review. guys who are watching, I want to tell you that actually I did a 20-minute video on my funny experience with finance P2P when it had just launched, right? And honestly, I do believe that peer-to-peer exchanges are not. Maybe, you know what, to say that they are better than the other exchanges, we can't say, because there are pros and cons to both. But peer-to-peer exchanges are definitely helpful in certain cases where you want to buy cryptocurrency for large quantity, you don't want to do multiple transactions, you want to send one transaction to one person and get done with it, and you don't want to go via exchanges bank, you just want to do transfers to the other person. So all these cases are like, all these things are good for P2P transactions. Ab isme hota ye hai that we also face problems of third party transfers aur kuch issues bhi aate hai wherein not the right kind of people are there on P2P platforms. But thankfully, at least on Binance, they have a verified merchant system. Matlab, if you are not verified by Binance, you cannot be a merchant on certain Indian exchanges like WazirX, who still has P2P. They have KYC done for their users. So those things help in mitigating the risks, right? But there are also other P2P exchanges which allow you to do other things, but everything comes with a risk. My point here is that P2P is going to be around for some time, or P2P exchange ek parallel exchange banega. And kal ko agar RBI ne phir se kuch ghafla kar diya aur cryptocurrency, you know, INR pe restrictions leke aa gaye aur banking transactions pe restrictions leke aa gaye, to P2P is going to be the one that will be used by everybody. Dusre, since Binance has invited me here, so I should talk nice things about Binance as well. So better ye bhi hai ki agar aap Binance mein trade karna chahte ho to Binance has like 200-300 altcoins. So aap P2P se us pe INR se directly khareed sakte ho BTC ya USDT, aur aap us pe Binance ke jo 200-300 coins hai unko un pe trade kar sakte ho. Fayda ye hai ki aapko P2P transaction ki koi fees nahi lagti hai. तो आप कंपेयर कर सकते हो कि अगर आपको इंडिया में कहीं पे लिक्विडिटी नहीं मिल रही है, कोई कहीं आपके पास ऑलरेडी यूएसडीटी या बीटीसी नहीं है और आपको आईएनआर से बाई करना है, तो आप बाइनेंस पीटूपी पे आईएनआर से बाई कर सकते हो. सो आई थिंक दैट वाज द क्रक्स ऑफ इट ऑल. चित्रल डिड अ ऑसम जॉब एक्सप्लेनिंग एंड शोइंग हाउ द बाइंग एंड सेलिंग वर्क्स ऑन बाइनेंस. I have made videos. There are 7 or 8 other people who have made great videos, short, big, lengthy, whatever you want, reviews, everything is there on YouTube. Binance have one of the world's largest exchanges, so it's imperative ki inke paas quality product ho, aur inke paas quality product hai. So I think that's my take. Like, P2P is necessary for certain cases jahan pe aapke paas aur koi choice nahi hai, ya aap खुद ये चाहते हो कि आप एक्सचेंज के थ्रू नहीं जाना चाहते और आप पर्सन टू पर्सन डील करना चाहते हो. एंड पी टू पी विल सर्वाइव अगर आरबीआई ने फिर से कुछ कर दिया तो, या बैंकिंग बैन लेके आ गए तो. And Loknath here is saying that I have to say nice things. I don't have to say nice things, okay? I can say bad things about Binance. It's not like they've put a gun on my head. They've invited me here and I really think ki Binance ke product acche hai. हाँ ये है और ये काफी लोगों ने इश्यू रेज भी किया है कि लिक्विडिटी कम है, ट्रेडर्स कम है, मर्चेंट्स कम है और इनफैक्ट वो कम इसलिए बिकॉज ये प्रोडक्ट नया है और ये सारे वीडियोस इसीलिए हो रहे हैं ताकि आप लोग खुद मर्चेंट बनो और ट्रेड करो इस पे. तो ऑब्वियसली सारी वीडियोस, सारी मार्केटिंग, सारी कम्युनिकेशन इसीलिए होती है कि वी कैन कन्वर्ट पीपल इनटू कस्टमर्स. तो जो 200 लोग देख रहे हैं वो उन लोगों को बोला जा रहा है इस वक्त दैट आप P2P ट्राई करो और बताओ उनको आपको कोई इश्यू दिख रहा है. तो दे आर लिसनिंग, दे आर यू नो दे विल टेक योर फीडबैक. सो डू इट, ट्राई P2P ऑन बाइनेंस एंड सी हाउ इट गोज फॉर यू. सिमरन, डू यू हैव एनी स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चंस फॉर मी? आई थिंक आई हैव एक्चुअली स्पोकन माय ओपिनियन ऑन P2P एंड बाइनेंस P2P ऑलरेडी.
That should be enough for now, I guess, Naimish. I think we can start with the question and answer round. Like, if you guys have a lot of questions already, but I think we should be in a position to answer. So all three of us can answer. Naimish, you can, you know, hand over the legal, community, etc. side. I can check off, you know, I can check out the other sections, and Chitra, you can do the P2P side.
Yeah. So the important question that I can see are a couple of them. Is one is the about the liquidity, and second is WazirX and Binance the same? So about the liquidity, as Naimish has clearly mentioned that the product is new. So yes, of course, there you will see that under Ethereum or EOS, there are no ads. So that is what we are aggressively working on right now to come up with merchant program. And we are have lot many things in pipeline, which you will hear very, very soon in coming couple of months. So we will, and from you, whoever is watching, if you want to become a merchant, please, we will be sharing the link with you. You can fill out that form, we will verify, and you can become a verified merchant on Binance and you can start trading. So it's community driven totally. We are trying, we are doing our best, and we are coming up with a lot of things to bring more and more liquidity on Binance P2P platform. Second question is WazirX Binance the same? So WazirX is the part of Binance ecosystem. Both the wallets can be linked. If you have your account in Binance, you can easily create your link, your wallet through WazirX. You don't have to do your KYC again. Once you have something, say you have bought on WazirX, you can transfer your balance to Binance. You can do P2P over there. You can do spot trading over there. You can do futures. There are a lot many products and services that Binance is offering. And you can play around. You can trade in a lot of things. There is staking, there is pool, a lot of features that you can explore. So WazirX is the part of Binance ecosystem.
Chitra, right, I see a couple of questions that are continuously being repeated. So can I take it on the...
Sure. Please go ahead.
So first question is around the balances, the amounts to be transferred. It's IMPS, someone is saying the limit is 1 lakh and NEFT is more than 1 lakh, but it takes 4 hours. So main ye clarify kar deta hu, IMPS limit is actually sort of 2 lakhs per transaction. I think, Simran, can you bring me up on screen? Like, I'm not a attention hogger, but like, I like to right. So IMPS limit is 2 lakhs. NEFT is more than 2 lakhs. You can do, or in fact, less than 2 lakhs also. You can do up to 5 lakhs. But the thing is that NEFT is almost instant. Okay. Like, in maximum, it takes is half an hour. So it's not that, you know, you will run into issues because Binance only gives a 30-minute window. The other thing is that you have a chat window as well, where you can explain the situation to the other person that this is what has happened. And because they are trusted merchants, right? So see, a difference is that you go to a P2P exchange, sometimes you are trading with someone you don't know. But in Binance, it's a trusted merchant, so they know who they are. And they have signed some contracts to ensure that they follow through in their trade. So they will understand. It's just a little better than the other systems that are out there. Maybe we can call it centralized. Kisi ne ye cheez raise bhi kiya hai ki hum centralized exchange ko kaise trust kare. It acquired WazirX and now it's starting its own P2P. I think it has nothing to do with WazirX because Binance already had P2P for other currencies. They've just launched it for INR. And the other thing that WazirX acquisition sort of gives Binance is an opportunity to enter India. And it's an acquisition, for God's sake. WazirX will be called Binance India tomorrow and you can't do anything about it. Okay. So it is a complete acquisition. It's not like they've sort of invested money into it. They can do whatever it is that they want with it. And if they do it, there are already competitors in India. So competition is good. People need to understand that. Competition is good. It keeps other people in check, right? So that's why it is all important that these things are taken. And as a user, you should be doing all these things and tell Binance what is happening, what is wrong. Maybe tell me. I have more connection. I can directly call Simran and tell her what is wrong. Okay, so you can come to CoinCrunch and tell me and I will tell Simran if there is a problem. Okay, so yeah, that's what I wanted to address. I think we can take a couple of questions. Simran, maybe you can take about the Binance being Maltese and Chinese and whatever, or legal implications. Wait, let me take another question from Manan here on legal. So Manan, cryptocurrency trading is completely legal. It's not really told by the government that it's legal, but also the government has not deemed it illegal, which means that we can freely do it. You can trade cryptocurrencies. There's nothing wrong with it. You can hold cryptocurrencies. So far, there's nothing wrong with it. You can even mine cryptocurrencies, but there's a problem with importing the machines by the customs. But other than that, there's actually no restrictions on trading cryptocurrencies right now.
All right. There are a lot of questions around when will Paytm wallet be added as the payment method. So guys, I see a lot of things here are about adding Google Pay, Paytm, etc. We're working on it. We're definitely working on it. Like a lot of people have told us that in the past, and we're working on it right now. So we can't really make a statement. But as soon as it's integrated, you guys are gonna get a mail that Paytm is on, Phone Pay is on, Google Pay is on. So you guys can do it like easily, make all the transactions easily. So to hold on for a bit, we just started the product. So give us some time to work on it.
Okay. I think Chitral should take two questions that are continuously coming up on this. How do we know that the blockchain transaction has happened, which is something that you can explain, right? Like, how do they ensure that the transaction is actually reflecting the right balance?
You're talking about blockchain transaction?
Yeah, so I think these people are thinking that when you do a P2P transaction, there has to be a blockchain transaction of BTC moving from one place to another, but there is an escrow service, right? So maybe we can talk about how it is escrowed.
So what happens in escrow services on Binance P2P is once you have made the payment, the seller will release the crypto to the address that it is there in your Binance wallet, Binance P2P wallet. Say for example, me and Naimish, I am the seller and Naimish is the buyer. So Naimish has paid in my bank account, ab mera responsibility hai to release those crypto. So wo jo mera crypto hai, that is already there in the Binance reserve funds. Jaise hi maine apna selling order place kiya hua hai, to wo jo amount hai, that will be under Binance reserve funds. So that after Naimish makes the payment, I don't run away with his money, right? So my crypto are already with Binance that time. After making the payment, what I have to do is click the order that please release my crypto. So my crypto will be released and it will be in Naimish Binance P2P wallet. Correct? So isme wallet is concerned. That is not any blockchain. That is a wallet to wallet. It's a Binance P2P wallet. I hope that I made that clear.
Yeah. I think that the idea is that P2P transaction is peer-to-peer sending fiat currency, and there is nothing like crypto. It's still a database entry like anything else, like any other trade, right?
There's a question here that says how to transfer from WazirX to Binance wallet. So it's by Nitin. Chitul, would you like to answer that?
So it's very simple. Once you have your Binance account already, so you can see the link option. You can directly link your WazirX and you can transfer. Let me see if I can show you. Actually, my account is already linked, so it will be difficult for me to शो यू बट देयर इज अ लिंक जो हम वी कैन डू वन थिंग सिमरन
देयर इज एन आर्टिकल ऑन इट आई विल सेंड इट टू यू गाइस कमेंट
या या लेट मी शो यू हियर इट इज आई विल शो आई विल शेयर माय स्क्रीन कैन यू सी माय स्क्रीन Can you see the article? Yeah. So this is the article when you will go to Binance blog, how to buy Bitcoin in India on Binance. So there are two ways. You can either do directly via Binance P2P, and second is buying via WazirX. So what you have to do is you have to, if you have already a WazirX account, you can click on this link and connect your WazirX and Binance accounts. So everything is there on this blog post, and there are the steps also how you can link and how you can transfer your funds between WazirX and Binance. This is the blog post dated 9th of June.
Can be. There are a lot of questions, Chitra. I think you should answer them. Like, there's a lot of P2P questions.
I am actually lost in this.
Can we do P2P without making account on Binance?
Sorry?
Can we do P2P without making account on Binance?
No, how can you do P2P without making account on Binance?
How can you?
Also, one important thing, when you are doing any transaction, you have to make sure that you see the bank account details and everything, verify the merchants or the seller's name or the buyer's name with the payment details and everything. And in case if the person asks to make you payment through some other method, be very cautious of it and stick to whatever is there listed on the Binance P2P by the merchant. For an transaction, मैंने अपना बैंक अकाउंट कुछ और दिया है एंड इन दी चैट विंडो आई विल आस्क नैमिश के नो अब आप उस अकाउंट में मत डालिए दिस इज माय अनदर बैंक अकाउंट डिटेल्स प्लीज ट्रांसफर मनी टू दैट देन नैमिश हैज टू ईदर डिक्लाइन द पेमेंट कैंसिल द ऑर्डर और ही कैन यू नो ब्रिंग दिस थिंग अप टू द बाइनेंस कस्टमर केयर सपोर्ट So as far as the trust issue and everything is concerned, Binance P2P customer support team is very, very, skilled and supportive in this case. Whatever appeal that you can do, there's an appeal button also over there. You can do the appeal and, you can talk to the customer support team and we will resolve the issue.
Okay. I can take up a couple of legal ones again. So one is will Binance share your details to income tax department? So I don't want to talk about Binance or anybody else, but any exchange needs to, if they have to give details to someone, they need to be specifically asked. So if the government officials get the warrant on Naimish's email address and go to Binance and say that give us details about this email address, they will comply. Any exchange will comply. But the government needs my exact email ID to do that and a proper warrant which will, ask them under the international treaty to sort of give away these transactions, which is a very difficult task. Okay, let's be honest. The other thing is that they might just give a Bitcoin address and say that who does this belong to, tell us. But again, the process has to be followed. There has to be a proper warrant with proper information that this is the details that we want. At least that's the benefit that comes with international exchanges because they have to go through a proper process. In India, however, an Indian exchange, they all follow these norms, but a new exchange might be, arm twisted by income tax department to give away some information. But other than that, some established exchange has good legal policies that stop them from giving your information without a proper warrant. Right, so that answers Satish or Sunny's question. Then one more was about KYC needed. Of course, you need KYC. Somebody was asking that what is the difference between Hawala and Binance P2P? Well, you need to do KYC to transact on Binance. So you are not, and you need to do only bank transfers. So you are not really doing a cash transaction or moving money out of India as such. The INR is still within India. Like you are just giving one from your account, you are giving INR to somebody else, or from somebody else's account, you are taking INR into your account. So you are not really moving money. So it's not really Hawala.
Okay, one question that I can take is, when I sell someone BTC for bank transfer on Binance, where does it deduct my BTC from? From my BTC wallet on Binance question, or does it buy from exchange at that moment and then exchanges? So when you want to sell your BTC for bank transfer on Binance, what you have to do is, first of all, from your spot wallet, you have to transfer your coins to the P2P Binance wallet, and from there you can place the sell order. So it is your coins which are there on the spot wallet which will be taken to the Binance P2P wallet, and from there you can place your order and you can sell your BTC.
One question somebody is asking me directly, which is how do they ensure that their transactions are safe, and to that, any centralized exchange has like even decentralized finance applications have an ability to be hacked, because there could be a loophole that somebody can exploit, right? So buy Bitcoin, if you are doing a long-term like investment, buy Bitcoin on exchange and then move it to your own wallet. That is one way to keep it safe. The other one is, see, every exchange has a potential to be hacked, but also we have to see that if the exchange has the ability to recoup the losses. So Binance recently lost 7,000 BTC. None of the customers actually got affected by it. Similarly, in India, one of the exchanges was hacked, CoinSecure. They pretty much refunded all the customers. I'm not sure if everyone was refunded, but they were able to refund a lot of customers, like majority of them. So if the exchange, if the exchange has enough liquidity, enough funds, enough backing behind them, even if they get hacked, your funds might stay safe, right? We recently saw that CoinDCX was also gave a bounty to the person who they realized that because of a security issue, they lost the funds. So this is how it is, right? You have to trust the exchange. It's not entirely secure, but if the exchange has enough backing, they will ensure that you don't lose funds. So that's how you have to take the gamble.
Another question is, do you have the chat support with customer care in case of P2P issue, because we want the transaction to happen quickly so that we buy the dips? Yes, we do have chat support. Once you place the order, there is a chat support between you and the buyer or seller, and you can quickly chat with them and get in touch with them. Second, the question that I also saw before was of the mobile numbers. So right now, the merchant can control whether they want to show their phone numbers or hide their phone numbers. It depends on them. We are adding the option for users as well, the same functionality. If they want to show the number, you can show. If you want to hide the number, you can hide, so that once you have made the payment or once you have placed the order and you want to chat or you want to talk to that person directly, you can do it. So that is one thing.
Okay. Chitral, can you answer the question that Gaurav is asking on the platform about what if the buyer doesn't pay, right? The dispute.
What does the buyer, if the buyer doesn't pay?
Yeah.
So if the buyer has placed the order and he has not made the payment, so of course automatically the order will get cancelled after the predefined time period. And if he has not paid, then of course your crypto will be released back to you. So you can appeal, or you can contact customer support that the buyer has not made the payment, and so I don't want to make the transaction, and the Binance Reserve funds will release your crypto and you will get back to your P2P wallet.
Also, Mohammed Shahid is asking, how do you secure transaction in P2P to safeguard both buyer and seller? Maybe one more time about the escrow service, that, you know, the funds are not with the buyer nor with the seller. They are held in escrow.
Right. So for an example, I am the seller. I hold USDT and Naimesh is the buyer. So once I place the sell order on Binance P2P platform, say 100 USDT, my 100 USDT will be reserved in Binance escrow services. So even if I want to make another order for 100, I cannot, because that fund is already reserved. For that fund, I cannot place any other ad. Now, once Naimesh makes the payment, he sends me the screenshot and in the chat window, he says that I have made the payment, please release the crypto. I will release it. In case if I'm offline or I'm busy in other work, and if I forget that I have placed an ad on Binance, blah, 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 Naimesh can raise an appeal to customer service on Binance that I have seen this, the order details you have to provide, the payment proof that you have to that he provides to customer support, that I've already made the payment. Binance team will reach out to me that Naimish has made you the payment, please release his crypto. If I don't get back to Binance customer support timely, then Binance has rights to release those crypto to Naimish account. So in this case, both me and Naimish are protected. So this is how Binance escrow protects both buyer and the seller, so that nobody runs with your money or your cryptos.
I'm going to share with people my tutorial as well, because it seems like that could solve all these problems, because I've spoken about these at length over there as well. Simran, do you think any other question has to be answered?
There are a lot of questions, but I think right now there's nothing technical, nothing significant enough. Like, guys, you guys need to ask better questions. So I think we should definitely do the do your tutorial, definitely. Share screen.
Sorry, no, I was not doing a tutorial now. Sorry. You want to share
the link, whatever? You want to share it?
Yeah, I shared the link on the chat, and maybe we can keep it in the description as well later.
All right, we can do that, definitely. Yeah. All right, Naimish, do you have anything to say? Chutul, do you have anything to say? Like, guys, do you guys have any actual questions apart from Wazir's acquisition and Binance? What happens if the person doesn't pay, etc.?
Okay, maybe let me wrap it up for just quickly 1 minute to explain P2P concept to everybody who's there, right? Okay. So P2P transaction essentially means it's peer to peer, one person to another. Exchange does not have the eyesight about, they don't have the visibility of the fiat transaction that happens. If INR moves from one account to another, exchange cannot see it unless you decide to show it to them. So exchange doesn't know INR. How do they keep the cryptocurrency safe, that, you know, buyer does not sort of, you know, take away, steal the funds and go, or seller does not take back his funds, is something called as an escrow service, which ensures that until the buyer and seller both are in agreement that the said amount has been sent by the buyer to the seller and the seller has received it, nobody can take those funds away, right? Nobody can actually access those cryptocurrencies. That's how it is secure. That is sort of explaining all the questions over there, right? Now about the rates and all, guys, P2P is something where you can decide the rates. You can sell it at $9,500 if you want. You can sell USDT at 80 rupees if you want. It's your choice. It depends on the demand and supply. If people are selling at 75 rupees and you are selling at 80, probably nobody will ever buy from you. So that's the case. It will happen, right? Okay, that's it from my side. I have another call at 4 o'clock, so I will end it here now.
All right, thank you so much, Naimish.
Yeah, thank you for having me. I was very happy to explain things to people. And Chitral, thank you so much for the demo. I think you did a better job than I did, to be honest, on my video, because I do a lot of talking. So this was very point to point. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Naimish. Thanks for your time.
All right, guys, so now that the session is coming to the end, we have a quick, really nice assignment for you guys. Like, whatever you guys understood from this, you know, webinar, go and, you know, use it in real life. Check out our P2P platform, use it, trade above $100, and we'll select the first 10 users and give them $20 worth of BUSD. So, and yeah, just do that. Tag us, tag me, tag one of our team, tag hashtag Binance at the rate P2P. That's it. Do all of these things and we'll get back to you and with your giveaways. So I think that's it from my side as well. We'll wrap up now. Chitul, you want to say bye?
Yeah, thanks to all the viewers who have taken out time to come and be on our webinar, and I hope to see you guys bringing us liquidity, signing up today and placing your orders, and look forward to many, many queries from you. In case if you still have any questions, we have our Binance India Telegram channel. Please feel very free to ask any questions that you want as far as Binance P2P is concerned or other products, and we are there happily, and we'll be answering it to you.
Yeah, guys, we are here for you guys. So just like, feel free to just reach out to us. So that'll be it from our side. All right, we'll close it now.
Yeah.
Bye, guys.
Okay.
Thank you, Chitral.
Thank you. Thanks all. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.